Howdy, internet. So we're finally getting back to working on this grinder stand. Life, it's Christmas. I'm just now getting back to it. Had to do some stuff in the shop, kind of off camera, just clean up and make it workable in here. And now I'm coming back to this. Took a minute to kind of think about what I wanted everything to look like. I wanted it to operate, some of that stuff. What I've landed on, this piece needs to get cut down a little bit because we're gonna use this little big hunk of metal here. We're gonna lop off, say a foot and a half maybe. Maybe not even that far, maybe just a foot. And that's what this will get welded to. Then on the bottom of this, we're gonna weld on some tabs that run lengthwise, about 10 inches long. This is 6 inches wide. And then we'll drill two holes through that. And the thinking being that this, when it's mounted, if you guys see there, but if the grinder is mounted right here, most of the force that it's gonna be experiencing is gonna be in a single direction. It's not gonna be omnidirectional. So once it's mounted, most of it's gonna go back and forth. That's why welding this to a long piece, this will run straight in to the wall. That provides a lot of weight to the base, which should help it from kind of jiggling and rattling and that sort of thing. And the stability for this to be well mounted. If I had a plasma cutter or an oxyacetylene torch, I might even cut a hole in this and inset it and then weld it in. But I don't, so I'm not going to worry about it. I'll just surface weld it and clean off a lot of this rust. I'll use this half, substantially less rusty than this. And I think that's going to work well for how it's going to set up. I'll probably take, this is 2 inches off. I'll probably take 2 or 3 inches off of the upright piece. And I think that's going to get everything to land pretty well where we want it. Hopefully it all works. I'm gonna jump to speed up and turn on my heater because it is cold in here. I believe it is still snowing outside, so it's a good December day here in Minnesota. I really gotta find a better way to deal with smoke in the shop. Because my big vent fan is great in the summertime, but in the winter when it's cold, just sucks all the heat right out of here. You can probably see my breath. So I've got the stand all welded together. The next part is going to be drilling holes in the concrete and setting the anchors in. First thing I'm going to do is just a little bit of cleanup here and deal with this mess. It bothered me, but I ran out of the Hobart 7018s that I usually like in the 8th inch. I have a box of 3/32, but for this gauge metal, that's just really small. So the amperage I have to run the rod at means it just is glowing red by the time I burn through a whole rod. So I'm definitely not a pro welder. I make do with the skills that I have available to me and the time I have to get better at it. But we may do with some of the Menards discount rods. I have to go to a Fleet Farm. That's the closest place to here where I can get Hobart filler materials anyway. So when I'm there, I'll get another box of 7018 eighth inch. Yeah, I'm gonna clean up this mess and just get some of the welder all packed up and out of my way so that I can start on the next part. I still don't have the bolts that I'm gonna need to anchor the stand to the concrete. I have bolts that will work for putting the grinder itself on the top. So I have to run into town yet today to check on my wife and I's cows. And I'll stop at Menards on the way and grab the right hardware and try and get this wrapped up tonight yet. Alright, so it's the next day. Meant to get back to this last night and didn't get home until 6 o'clock or something after I was taking care of animals. So finally getting to it again this morning. I've got everything I need. I've got my goodie bag from Menards. Bunch of stuff here, but the big thing that I got was an assortment of bolts. I ended up just getting grade 8 because they're not that much more expensive than the grade 5, and I tend to need grade 8 more than I need grade 5. So got a bunch of bolts, got new safety glasses because my other ones are a little bit scratched, and another pair of gloves. So we're going to knock out these holes in the bottom with the hammer drill, get all of our anchors installed, and get this project wrapped up so I can move on to the next thing. This is a pretty classic issue where I am off by maybe a 16th with this whole placement and what's drilled in the concrete, and I just can't get them quite to line up. So I'm going to take a little bit more out of the holes. That'll give me a little more wiggle room. And hopefully this is the right size bit for doing that. test this, see how it does. I'm a little worried about that vibration, that this thing might get a little out of hand. If that's the case, I will think of some way to fix that, but I'm gonna turn it on and see what happens. Actually, I'm gonna put on gloves first and then I'm gonna turn it on. Just in case something goes whack. That's actually perfect. It doesn't seem to be shaking any. It's nice and firm. I think we nailed it. On to the next project. Thanks for watching.